Hi everyone, this is Andrea from the Art and Nature Center, and for today's project, we're going to be creating a few different types of oil and water paintings. So these kind of double as an art project and an experiment. Oil and water are two different types of liquids that will never mix together. So when we're doing this on our paper, they'll always repel each other and never mix or stick together in the same spot. So the materials we need are any kind of cooking oil. I'm just using a vegetable oil. And water, for the color that you're going to mix with the water, you can really use any paint that mixes with water, so it's water-soluble paint. So I'm using acrylic. You can use liquid watercolors or even food coloring works great. So I have these little containers that I'm pouring the paint in and mixing with some water. So just squeezing some in and then adding the water. I don't have a specific amount or ratio for this. I'm kind of just eyeballing it. So the first method, we're gonna do a drip. So we're gonna drip the oil and the paint onto our paper. So I'm using watercolor paper. You can use any thicker, maybe like a Bristol board paper, but watercolor paper works great. I'm gonna wet my paper first just because I like that effect. And then I'm going to place it on a covered surface because sometimes this can get a little messy. And for dripping my oil, I'm going to use this little dropper tool. Maybe like an eyedropper or something from like a medicine bottle would work great. And it's up to you how many drops and how big they are on your paper. So I've dripped my oil. Now I'm going to drip some paint. Start with my red. Because I wet my paper, you can really see that the color really bleeding through the paper. Oil and water repel each other. I don't want to go too crazy on saturating this paper, but I do want to get another color in there. You can see, even if I drip it on top of the oil, it's not going to mix. And as these dry, they definitely reveal a lot more. All right, so that's my first method, the oil and water drip. So I'm going to carefully put this one aside, and like I said, as it dries, it's gonna get even more interesting. So the next one is color dip. So what I'm gonna do is pick one of my colors, and I just have a flat plastic tray. You can use a shallow cooking tray if you want. So for this, I'm gonna fill it with paint and water mixed together, just enough to dip my paper in. Just mix it together. No specific measurements. I think that's probably good enough. So now I'm going to take my dropper and my oil and drip it right into my red paint. And this is cool because you can see really well the oil float right on top. And this is where you can decide, you know, the size of your droplets or how many you've got in there. I think I've got a good amount. I'm going to take this piece of paper and make sure I have my paper towel to place it on. And I'm just going to gently dip it on the surface. You'll start to see the oil saturating through the paper. That's kind of my cue to pull it out. Move it around a little. So you can leave it like that, or take it a little further and drip in a few more colors, which is what I always like to do. I'm gonna add some yellow also. Get all three of them in here. And like I said with the first one, these will change a little bit as they dry. All right, so that's our oil dip. So we're gonna do one more process. Let me just get this one out of the way. So for the last one, we're gonna take the tray of just plain water, and we're gonna mix our paint directly into the oil. I've already got some in these cups, but I'm gonna add a little bit more because you'll notice the paint won't mix into the oil the same way it does with the water, but you can get it to evenly like disperse itself into the oil. You'll see like little little beads of paint, and that's how we want it to be mixed in there. So I'm going to do a couple colors of that. Really scoop up the little beads of color and the oil and drip it into my water. You can kind of see like those chunks of color stay inside some of the bubbles of oil. Let me add some yellow. Make sure I have a paper towel to put it on. I'm going to dunk this one all the way into the water. And pull it up. And it already looks really, really cool, but this is the one that will change the most as it dries. So those are my three oil and water painting processes, and I'm sure there's a bunch of different ways that you can mix and match these processes to keep experimenting. Let me show you a few already dried examples of what we did today. These two are dried oil dips. So when we made the red paint in the water and dipped, I did this with blue, so that's how it dries. And then this is the first method we did where I just wet the paper and then dripped both the oil and the paint on there. And then this is the final process that we did where we mixed the paint with the oil and then dripped it in the water. So that one really marbled in a very cool way. I hope you enjoy these processes and really have fun and experiment with what you're doing, and please share your artwork with us. Thank you so much for joining me.